Winnie's dude. Time traveling gizmos until we get putting off our mojo.
Also remember that new student participation is encouraged, yeah? So like, if you see someone who is behind someone and you're like, far out, man, there's someone behind you, you should say, he's behind me. What was that? Oh, come on, let's hear it. He's behind you! What? Who is?
No, 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 no. People are just trying to make a point, yeah?
Points!
What, where?
Points.
Oh god, the sky is falling upwards, man!
Nicely. Quite.
like a simple case of hysteria. Perhaps we should get her out of sight.
Yes, good idea, Mr. Bitterman. I wonder what could have done this.
It looks like an attack of the Broomiest Bandersnatch.
Don't be ridiculous. The Bandersnatch is a myth.
Maths or anything that might fuzzy our pretty little brains. Dinner. I'm afraid it's put off. 2.5% downturn in my annual income. It does wipe a shift into a lower tax bracket. You see, Master Shackington, every kind of silver mining, you should have it.
Right, pay attention, class. Today's lesson is all about how to prepare a nutritious breakfast. Breakfast, one of the three most important meals of the day, excluding snacks, of course.
Smashing! I'm feeling rather peckish. I'll have some sausages, poached eggs, a serving of porridge, and some lashings of ginger beer.
Rossages?
Yes, and some for my friend as well.
Oh, no, dear. In this class, you learn how to make breakfast, not eat it.
God, woman! You have served for that kind of thing? I heard things had slipped here in the colonies, but it's disgusting!
Stanislavski. My thrilling purveyors of the arts, what imaginings shall we discover this year?
Oh, no, the Bandersnatch got the drama teacher.
That's just how Mr. Danger is, sir.
So you're sure you're not dating Fred? 100%.
Well then, would you by any chance happen to know his favorite type of cookie?
Sure, it's chocolate with chocolate chips and chocolate icing.
No, no! Oh, no, 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 no!
Hey Fred, would you like a cookie I made in Hermes?
Actually, Miss Cook, she
has... Well, they're really delicious. Go on, have one. Everyone's tried one.
It's a trap.
Mr. Jones, you put that cookie down right now. You will not put any of that carb-filled, fatty-filled into your mouth.
Much fun, protein.
Not only are you the lead in the class play, but you are also the star performer in the after-school ecstasy club. I can't have you rolling around the stage now, can I?
No, sir.
Now, tell me, how many sit-ups have you been doing each morning?
The Ecstasy Club is 18, Brad. You gotta get your head in the game or you're letting everybody down.
Yeah? Well, I've been thinking.
What?
Maybe I don't want to do ecstasy anymore. See how destructive ecstasy can really be.
Then, Fred, what could possibly be destructive about ecstasy?
It's true, there's nothing inherently wrong with it. It's just that I sort of want to join the basketball team.
Basketball?
Yeah, the basketball. And everyone knows you can't do more than one extracurricular activity at a time.
Fred, you don't want to look like an overachieving nerd like that Valerie Dorkly.
My freshman year, I know I'm the best you've got, and that the club would fall apart without my talent keeping you afloat, but I just feel like I was made for something bigger and better.
I'll have none of that, Mr. Jones.
Ecstasy is in your blood, girl. If you put on a glove, not only would you be ruining it for everyone else...
But you are out of my class!
You can't do that! Can't I?
You wouldn't stop begging me to come and keep you company. If you leave now, I'll be all alone.
All right, for you, Dad. But if I don't get all the best parts, I'll be going straight to the deputy headmistress's office and breaking free!
Now that we have that nonsense out of the way, it's time for an announcement. To keep our play relevant to current affairs, I've decided to introduce a new character.
That's right, girlfriends. The main characters will have to face the most hideous, most vile, most disgusting creature that they, or the audience, have ever seen.
And it just so happens that I've cast the perfect person. Congratulations, Daphne Blake.
Congratulations, your first class, and you've already been cast as a disgusting freak.
Now, Daphne, there are no small parts, just small actors.
Like Danny DeVito.
Now, go get your costume on. I need to see how it fits.
Posters up for a production of Rent that's coming out next week. Well, I thought maybe we could all go together.
No! That company is the devil! Its show is going to be a disaster.
Why do you say that, sir?
Well, it's obvious that they have no eye for real talent. I auditioned for the role of Mark.
the white, spiky Jewish boy. But instead, they cast some hack just because he was shortlisted for a Tony.
Tony, Tony, you gotta get down there, Tony.
Interview me.
Wait for me.
A very snatch in Coolsville High. We clown in your presence. Making him crazy.
What do you think we should do about this?
Well, you better hide your students, hide your teachers, and hide your janitor, because they'd be scaring everybody out here.
You heard it here first.
Right, go ahead.
Run and tell that, homeboy.
Indicating that you slept on the streets by a train station next to a homeless woman who stole your wallet. Which you never saw again. And finally, the stretch on your sweater here indicates that you ate a bad taco for breakfast before returning on a bus that smelled of old socks and tequila. Ah, you see? Genius.
Yeah, Holmes. Brilliant, isn't it? If you want a piece of the action, we're also available for birthday parties. Here, here's my card. Please call us if you ever require our very personal services.
Right. Mulder and Scully, what about you?
Can't talk about it. Very classified information.
Aliens.
What?
Aliens, it's always aliens.
Damn it, Mulder, I can't take you anywhere. Don't listen to him, he's drunk. Oh.
Shut up, jerk face.
No, you!
Provide me with any information I need to know instantly. It gets me where I need to go and allows
chaps doing here? What? You're hiring 3 kids and a dog over us? Come on, let's go make our own bloody pantomime to decide.
Anita, you don't have a leg to stand on. Ben, the school is already becoming a playground of Bandersnatch. Pretty soon, there will be nobody left.
You think you can threaten me?
I know I can.
Thank you.
You're a pretty good friend. Is something bothering you? Or?
I mean, I know it's shallow, but sometimes I feel like I'd fit in better if I was, well, beautiful.
Yeah, probably.
So much sense. I say, friend, did you know that a man named Dog created the universe?
Are you dyslexic?
Yeah!
Drama guy, gonna break free. Let me take a football. Whoa! Ha ha! talkative.
Now he's just acting like a moody teenager. It must be the chemicals.
What the devil is going on here? What do you think you're doing? You see the mess you've made? You can't just go about soiling the halls of education and expect to get away with it. No! I don't want to hear it. To Denton's for all of you!
What?
Right now.
Jinkies! Now I understand!
I guess. But it's true. I wanted to get rid of all the pretty, popular, and smart girls. Everyone looks at me as the mother figure. No one thinks that I'm sexy or cool. And I want that. I want that for just once. Unfortunately for you, I have the perfect plan for such an accusation.
My really, what's that?
Scooby-Doo! It's my girl!
good.
Also, Cam and Daphne. Sorry, I don't know why your character name.
Nice face. Cam, it's still there.